Okay, what's up, everybody? Good evening and welcome to the training call tonight. It's our Tuesday, Thursday live training. We do this every Thursday, and you know, the aim is to bring you the tools, you know, the trainings, the knowledge to help you crush it in your business. All right, so just like we always say, you don't have to be great to start. Well, you have to start to be great. Okay, so this is part of the education, part of you know, the things we put in place to ensure that you learn what it takes to succeed. So I'm very excited about today's call because I have one of my very good friends, someone I respect a lot. He's been in the game for for quite a while and really actually creating that success. So I wanted to bring someone from out there how this actually works, and we are talking about how to build your business using the internet. All right, so it's not news anymore that, you know, the internet is a real thing. It's here to stay. We are all online, and we have Facebook, we're on Instagram 24/7. So why not learn how you can use, you know, the internet to actually build your business? All right, is that something you would love to learn? So without much further ado, I'm going to bring up my friend here. His name is Gordon, all the way from Malta, and he's ready for us. Now, this is someone, as I said, I've known him for 6 years, and he's just an incredible guy. Just came back from boot camp in Ireland, so he came back without fire, and I'm sure we're going to get a lot of nuggets. So get your notes. I already have my notebook here to take notes. And basically, Gordon, we just want to learn from you how we can actually build and create. If you're ready, bro, the floor is yours.
Awesome, man. Thanks for that incredible introduction, my friend, Adeposi. And it's great to be here. Excited for you, those who are watching this, maybe also the recording. Let us know in the comments below where you are watching us from, which city you are in Nigeria, or maybe in some other country around the world. Maybe you're traveling for vacation. And if you have any questions, I will dedicate some time at the end also for your questions. So then Adeposi will pick a couple of questions that I can answer for you as well. So yeah, excited to be here, as I said, live from Malta after boot camp. We had a great boot camp actually a couple of weeks ago now, and with around 4,000 or 5,000 people, all from around Europe. And we had some phenomenal event right in there as well, together with the team. So in today's call, I just want to start a bit about my story, how I got involved with this, and how the internet, you know, the internet and started building my own brand helped me and is still helping me, because this is a process, like we always say, to open up and build, not just locally, starting locally, but going global as well. So before I did this, I was a chef, a professional chef. I did that for 13 years. So since after I left my catering college that I went for 4 years, I never did any other kind of jobs rather than just being a chef. So I didn't know to do anything else rather than preparing and cooking, right? So it is that moment that at the end of 2009, I started a food blog because the internet was getting in. And I set up a food blog. I don't know, don't tell me how exactly I managed to build a blog or a website, but I just followed someone on YouTube and I started to put myself in action, like mirroring what they were doing, and I had a blog. The good thing was to see the power of the internet came because people from Australia, from India, from Africa were asking me for recipes. And then I said, wow, this is a phenomenon. What's this, you know? So that simple seed, that one seed, started the journey on learning, being a student mode, learning also how the internet operates. And what we have the possibility in here, okay, is to merge three things. Merging the travel, which is the largest industry in the world, okay? 89% of the pictures that you see on Instagram, on Facebook, guess what? Are all travel related. Okay, have you ever thought about this? So this is the thing, you know, people are showing, want to show where they want to go, where they are right now, or where they have been a couple of weeks ago on vacation. So they brag about it, right? So second thing is the internet. We already talked about it. Businesses change, everything is changed. and we are changing with what we're showing you in here. And third thing is the network marketing field. It is more based on how you are positioning yourself right now. Don't wait for next year, right now in 2019, to prepare for the next 5 years, 10 years. That's what is the essential thing in here. And this is what we're going to talk about on this call. So basically, from then on, I started to follow certain people that taught me a lot of things. You know, those 3 a.m. webinars, 4 a.m. webinars in US, they didn't go wasted, let me tell you, because I was always, and I am still right now, on student mode. I'm not a finished product by far. This is all about executing, having the right systems set in place, and you just do the work, okay, on a consistent basis. So those trainings I started, I learned, and I implemented. And what I want from you, okay, for those who are watching this live or replay, once again, is to implement. Do not bother where, it's not about where you're from. It's not about where you're watching us. It's not about your background, okay? As I told you, I was a chef, okay? It's what you do with the information that it's out there and it's here in front of you. So how to build your brand, how to use the internet to grow your business. So again, there is the offline world, which is the number one thing that keeps doing what you're doing when it comes to offline. It's something that reinforces the relationships and the rapport with people. But how I managed to get outside, I live in a small island in Malta. I don't know, for those who don't know, go Google Malta. It's a small island below Italy. We are only 400,000 people. So when I started this project, I already planted a seed. In fact, I have a whiteboard. After the presentation, when I signed up, I came home and I started drawing circles, not with people, but with countries. Okay, listen to this. So I had planted the seed from day one that I'm not just gonna stay local, but I'm gonna go global. So the internet is one of the keys that allowed me to do this. And number one thing is because I started working on my brand. If you can see, if you go on my Facebook profile, okay, we're gonna mention Facebook because this is what I use to build. You can use Instagram, same methods, but I'm gonna mention Facebook a lot in here, is because I build my brand. See, people, they don't join companies, they join you. So it is three things that I'm gonna focus on in here as how you can build your personal brand. So number one thing, and I always mention this, is you need to give a facelift. If you haven't used Facebook, okay, for those who are newbies in here, they never worked or they don't know what it is to build their brand, is number one, give a facelift of your Facebook. I'm gonna give you some tips in here, or it could be Instagram, but I'm gonna focus on one social media just to make things simple because that's who I am, right? So what do I mean by facelift? So number two things that most people will eventually click on you to check you out is your timeline cover and your profile picture. So if you have, let's start with the profile picture. So if you have a shot, an image of yourself, okay, that is with your cat, or maybe there are cats in there, or maybe there is, I don't know, dogs, or maybe kids, I suggest you to remove that picture. I want you to put your face. Profile picture, okay? You can go and ask someone to take a picture in a good lighting, okay? Maybe in the morning or afternoon where there's good lighting. It's not important. The background is just that it's you, because again, you're branding you. So that's step number one, and that's already the first thing that you should do if you haven't got a great profile. Second thing is your billboard. I call it a billboard. It's timeline cover, right? The timeline cover that shows on mobile, shows on your laptop or computer. And this is where, what I want you to do is this. You can take example, if you go on my profile and check it out, you can, if you don't know design, this is where people get stuck, Adaposi. People get stuck is because they don't know how to design it. They don't know how they can do it as someone they follow. So here's two tips. If you don't know anything, you can get someone to do it for you. It can cost you $5 to $10. You can go on fiverr.com, F-I-V-E-R-R.com. Somebody can type it in the comments below, Okay, you can go and get someone to do it for you if you don't know where to start. Or if you want to be adventurous, you can go on canva.com, that's www.canva.com, and there are already the sizing of timeline covers in there, and you can start and do your online timeline cover. I suggest you to put your image in there, and maybe what's your passion about, what's the purpose, who are you targeting, who you want to help, okay? It's very, very important. So these are already some two things that can help you. Also, what I like is I put like click here on the thumbnail or tap here on the timeline cover. And something that helps me a lot is I show people who I am and I share my story. So you can dedicate some time and write your own story. Why you're doing this? Why you started this business? Why you are in network marketing? Why you're doing this? Okay, what's your why? What did you do? Start with what you did in the past. What clicked? What made you shift that mindset and make a decision to take and partake a different path? And this is why you decided. Do not mention, this is a bad thing, do not mention the company name or the products, okay? Because I will show you in the third and last step what you need to focus on as when it comes to posting. So wherever it is live or post. So we're gonna mention that the third step. So that's one step. First step, profile picture, timeline cover, okay? Make sure if you have photos that are blurry, remove them. If you are, maybe you were 18 or 20 and you have pictures getting drunk and things like that, please remove them. You get to understand, this is your page, this is your billboard, okay? For me, that's my business. This is part important part of my branding, and it should be also for you. So let's go on step number two. So step number two is what to post. Actually, I'm gonna tell you now, and how to find people that could potentially become customers, Dream Trips customers, and also representatives with you that join your team. So let's focus on Lagos, okay? Right now, most of you are in Nigeria, so what you need to do is ask yourself, what are three things that you love doing, that you have passion about? What are you passionate about? Is it sports, maybe soccer, maybe you have your favorite team, let's say Liverpool for this example, okay? I'm not with Liverpool, but let's pick up an example. So what I want you to do is, I want you to pick 5 to 10 groups in relation with your passion. And I want you to join those groups. Make sure that they have between 1,000 plus members with also there is activity in there. Okay? Why? It's because that's what you, because of this, you are passionate, you are gonna be giving value to what your passion is about. So if you're a fan of Liverpool, okay, and now there is the transfer market right now, and you're engaging with someone, maybe you know that Liverpool are gonna sign up a player, you can give value. Maybe you went to watch them at the stadium, you can show the pictures. Maybe someone asking something, you can help them because you are passionate about the club. So it could be maybe there's a lady and maybe it is, I don't know, photography that you're passionate about, or maybe something else, like, I don't know, volleyball, another sport. Doesn't matter. What matters is go and find these groups and join them and give value, like, engage. This is what it's all about. This is what it's all about when it comes to social media. And guess what will happen? Eventually, people are going to click on you because they're going to see you popping up with notifications every single time because you are being active, and activity brings results. So people can click on you. They can check you out. This is why you need to have a professional made and attractive facelift Facebook profile, okay? And this is when they can send you a message and you can start forming, and after forming, then you can show them the deal, share them the information. And this is what I'm doing on a daily basis, okay, when it comes to activity, okay? That's what I'm doing. So the other thing is, what kind of posts? Okay, so that's your target market. You can join just ladies if you want, just women in your team. If you want mixed, there's a ton of options. But focus on 5 groups that you decide to be active every single day, giving out value. They could be pages. Some of you may ask me, can I join pages? Of course, you can go on maybe speakers. Check out speakers in Lagos. Maybe there's a community about speakers. That's great, great target market for people to check out the business. Maybe there is authors. Okay, who do you know who have a lot of following when it comes to authors in Nigeria or in Lagos? This is what the kind of search that you need to do. That's your homework. Now, when it comes to third thing, okay, when it comes to branding, is the consistency and your work ethic. Okay, your work ethic. So basically, it's the strategy that you're gonna implement. You see, most people think that what you should focus on 90% is the posts on your profile, but that's not the thing. Okay, 90% is the activity you do when nobody is watching. Okay, messaging people, talking with people, forming people, getting interested in what they're doing, and then you can ask them then if they are open to check out the information, and you can add them to the group of group, or maybe you can do a Zoom call or WhatsApp call, whatever it is that fits you best. Okay, so what do I mean of posts? You see, you need to have a strategy. So I don't want you to be 24/7 in front of your computer or on your phone, but I want you to have a strategy. You see, you need to post when people are actively on the phone checking out their social media. So it can differ from where you are. It can differ from different countries, but you need to test. You see, what I do is I post afternoon. Sometimes I post, usually, this is honestly, I post usually once in a day. Okay, so you can start posting twice a day, one post between 12 p.m. okay, and 2 p.m. It could be a text, for example, something that people, while they are at work, it could be a quote, less than 85 characters that people can read and they can like and they can engage. In the evening, where people come after work, between 7 p.m. or 6:30 p.m., let's say 6:30 p.m. till 9, you can post something with picture, image, and I highly suggest you to put your image. You see, what I post is three things: lifestyle, travel, motivation, inspiration. That's what you will see if you go on my profile. So that's what the kind of people, you know, positivity, that's the attraction marketing that I want people that could be potentially be business partners or people who join as a customer. So what I do, I target those kind of people. So what you're doing is, and we are blessed, we are in the in a travel concept, you know, everybody loves to travel, right, as we say. So it's easier to come up with content. You can go, people tell me about, hey, I don't travel much right now because I just got started or I don't have the money. Okay, don't make that an excuse. I know that in Lagos, there are some places who, I've never been to Lagos, so I want to see that place. So go in a nice place, go in there if there's a lake, go if there's a nice park, whatever it is, and take pictures. And I highly recommend you this thing, that what helped me go to the next level and when it comes to branding is the quality of the images. So nowadays, there's phones like this, you know, that can take high quality images and also videos, or you can get a camera, small camera, HD, okay, with few $100, you can get it for high quality. Don't post pictures and images with blurry images, or especially when you go live, which is something that I will recommend, what as types of posts that you need to do, that you can do, make sure that there is no noise, no babies crying and things like that, because people, once they start watching you, okay, watching the live, and there's a lot of noise, they just exit and they don't follow what you're doing, the content that you're doing. So those are the three type of posts that I do, okay, travel, lifestyle, and inspiration. And also when it comes to timing, you know, what to post, text less than 85 characters. You can go live two times or one time a week. You can decide a date in a week. Maybe it's Thursday, maybe it's Friday, maybe it's in the weekend, and make it consistent. It's like your show. You see why TV shows are big around the world. You know, Game of Thrones, it was every Sunday, at certain time in US. So people are like excited to go and watch them. This is the same thing that you can do because this is your channel, not just your billboard, but also your channel. So that you can interview people, you can share knowledge, you can share notes from events that you've attended. Okay, don't let your notes sleep and die on the shelves or maybe drawers in your office, but use those notes and share them with people. It's all about creation of content. Okay, this is the number one question why people don't create content is because they don't know where to start. So that's where you start. Get the notes, share them with people, because number one thing that I learned and I'm sharing with you right now is to create your audience with these things that I shared with you. Okay, facelift of your Facebook, where to find the like-minded people, you know, that you have passion, the same passion with, so you can make a conversation. It's easy to make a conversation. What kind of posts that you are gonna do? I don't recommend sharing like Tony Robbins quotes on your profile. It must be you, pictures of you, you in the video, okay? Don't share war things or negativity things or political things, okay? Just focus on having your profile. It's all about you because you're branding yourself. Last thing is that I want to conclude, if there is any questions I can help with Adebozi, just let me know, is that consistency. This is not something that you do 1 week in, 1 week out, but it's consistency. Just have a strategy. Where you're gonna post, what time, so people can start engaging. And okay, go and talk with people. It's all about building relationship. Don't expect that by doing these three steps, people are gonna talk with you every single day. You've got to reach out as well. So a thing or two that I do is, if I find someone that commented some great comment, I just send them a message. I don't send them a friend request in the beginning, but I want to see if they are ready to build rapport. And then we can just take it to the next level. So building rapport, 90%, to conclude, 90% focus on building relationships, building rapport, giving value. 10% is what to post on your profile. Over to you, my friend. I hope that you guys found value. Let me know. Let us know in the comments below. And if you have any questions, I'm here for you.
Thank you so much. That was awesome. Can you hear me?
What's that?
Can you hear me?
Yes. I can hear you.
Great. So thank you so much. I mean, I've been here taking notes. I'm not that new to, you know, the online world and all that, but it's always great to learn what's working from others in the industry and see where you can make adjustments. So I just wanted to buttress one of the things you said concerning, you know, building online, attracting the right kinds of people. So, and you know, one funny thing, while I was doing an audit of my account, I went back to, I think when I first got into World Ventures, like the very first day I got into World Ventures, and I went to my Facebook profile and I saw some of the things I wrote there on my profile. And I was like, oh my God, I can't believe I did this. You know, I just went on there. I was very excited and I said, oh, come and join this company. Looking back now, I can't imagine that I would write something like that. But it always happens when, you know, people are excited, they want to get this thing going, and they go on their social media profiles, pages, and just start typing the name of the company, come and join me, we'll make money together, we'll travel the world, blah, blah, blah. You know, so just that mindset shift that, you know what, it's not about you, you know, hunting for people or you spewing out your links and hoping that somebody will join. It's more about becoming a person of value that people want to associate with. And when you become a person of value, posting content, like you said, valuable content, you know, people now want to, you know, be a part of you, just hang around you and work with you. All right. So, but I wanted to quickly ask something, because a lot of people here on my team, they're doing this part-time, you know, they are working a day job and, you know, they're trying to make extra money on the side, you know, and just get that financial freedom. But when we start talking about, okay, you know, we need to post online, go on Facebook, they're like, I don't think I have the time to do that. All right. I don't think I have the time. And I could answer that question of the time thing, you know, but I want to get your take on somebody that just, you know, started in the business and they're still trying to find their way and they feel they don't have the time to do it. You know, what do you have to say to them? How can we actually carve out time, you know, and begin to put these things in place?
Yeah, great question. Actually, great question that I have this question being asked all the time, you know, all the time. And I was in that situation. I was in the same shoes as most people, you know, starting on a spare time. So what they need to focus on is what time they can do this. What time? What's their time limit? You know, if you work, I have a guy that started a few weeks ago. This guy works from 10 a.m. He's a personal instructor from 10 a.m. till 8. So he's working his business, okay, from 9 till 1 a.m., 2 a.m., okay? That's his time. You could work from 8 till 4, 8 till 5, or 9 to 5, but it's not that. Don't make that's your work. That's fine. What you should focus on is, look, to post something, it only takes a few minutes. You're not going to need a lot of hours, but what you need to put more effort in and time is connections, building rapport, turning strangers into friends. That's what you need to focus on. So I can give you a tip, huge tip in here is, what is your number? What is your number? Is it 10 people? Is it 5 people? If you don't have a lot of time, just try to focus on connect with 5 new people every single day from these groups that I mentioned, from pages that you are following. That's the goal. When it comes to posting, and as I said, it's not going to take you a lot of time, but focus on messenger, building this rapport, asking, forming people, you know, FORM or FORD, okay? I call it family, occupation, recreation, and dreams. What are the dreams? Find out what their dreams are, why they can't do it, why they are in the same shoes, they don't have the time. You have the key throughout the opportunity that we're working on.
Awesome. Thank you so much. And I mean, that you just said exactly what I would say, because, you know, when I first started building this, I was working an 8 to 5 as an architect, working full time. But while everybody would make, you know, excuses as to why they didn't have the time, what I was doing was, while I'm on the bus going to work, you know, that's time. Okay, a lot of people are just watching movies or, you know, playing music in the air or doing nothing. Your break time, that's time, you know. So instead of taking a 1 hour break, I'll take my lunch in 20 minutes and then, you know, basically buy back time. And then on my way back home, that's time on the bus. You're doing nothing. I'm buying back my redundant time, you know. And I realized that already just doing that, that's about 4 hours in Lagos on the bus going to work, your lunch break. And after that is 4 hours. That is productive work that can be done if one just puts their mind to it, you know. So that's really awesome. Yeah, so we've been on for about 30 minutes, and I think we've got real value from here. And we just need to implement it, right? Personally, I do something talking about, you know, your show, where you were saying, building your audience and, you know, posting content out there. I have something I do every Saturday, Wealth Crusade. So I branded myself as the Wealth Crusader. And there are people in this group that actually signed up, you know, through that. Yeah. So, and so every Saturday night, once every week, same time, I go out there and I post out content, you know, and then people are attracted to me. So these things work. It's just about putting our minds to it, right? So before we let you go, Gordon, I know you're busy and I know you have to go back and get to making the money. But before you go, just give us one last tip. One tip, you know, to all the guys on the call today and those that will be watching the replay, you know, how we can take their business to the next level. It doesn't have to be online. It could be anything around business and just getting successful.
Awesome. I like this. One last thing that I can share with you guys is, do not compare yourself with others. This is something that is called comparitis. A lot of people will stop doing the work, will stop doing the basic, will stop moving forward, is because they compare, they look what somebody else is doing, okay? Or because they just started 2 months ago and they hit a certain rank in the company and you just, it took you more than that. It's your journey. So this is not a sprint, it's a marathon. So do not compare yourself with others. This will help you and somebody else in your team who are watching us right now, if you have tagged them in this call in here. So that's my last message. Thanks for the opportunity to share some stuff with your guys in Africa, my friend. And you're doing some phenomenal things, especially with this with these interviews. And I will see you at the top, with you at the beaches of the world.
Definitely. Thank you so much. Thank you so much. Really appreciate it.
You're welcome.
Awesome, guys. So that was Gordon. I mean, you can feel the heat, guys. You can feel the heat just coming out of boot camp, and he's just doing amazing things in Malta. Actually looking forward to maybe I'm gonna ask him offline when we can get him to come to Lagos very soon. So man, guys, you heard it. It's all there. You know, go out there, take these things, implement them, and you will start to see results, okay? This is not, I mean, we're not trying to get rich in 30 days or get rich in 2 weeks. These are things that you can use and begin to apply and start building a serious residual-based business. That's what we are here for. We're here for the freedom, not just some extra change. We're here for the freedom. And we're teaching you the strategies, teaching you what we are doing that is working, right? So you can do the same thing, okay? Because in this business, you know, we don't win if you don't win, okay? For me to get to where I want to get to, you need to get to, I need to help you get to where you want to get to, all right? So thank you so much for jumping on the call. We do this every Thursday night, trainings every Thursday night. If you have questions about this, just go back to the post and put it in the comments. I know Gordon is also in the group, so he can answer those questions, and any of the other leaders can also jump in. So thank you so much. We're going to end it right there, and I'll see you next week on the next training call. Go out there and crush it. God bless.